This is about Hidilyn Diaz's journey. Just a brief narrative about our newest sports hero who did not even know what the Olympiad was all about when she was a kid. From her humble beginnings in Barangay Mampang, Zamboanga City, to the Olympic spotlight in Tokyo, Japan, where she delivered a performance to capture the gold medal that eluded the Philippines for nearly a century. This is Chip from Game High, and in this video, we'll talk about Hidilyn Diaz and her encounter with the sport of weightlifting, her initial participation in weightlifting events, her initial achievements as well as the ups and downs of her career, and her international success culminating in victory in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. Before we go further, if you like this content and you want to see more high-quality videos about games and sports, subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon for notification. Feel free to leave comments, engage with us, or with anyone still hungover from the winning moment that stormed the nation. Hidilyn started her journey towards Olympic glory in Zamboanga City when she was 11 years old. Used to carrying pails of water when she was young, her relatives brought her to the attention of one Albert Atilano, a university professor and a former national weightlifting coach. Hidilyn became interested in weightlifting due to the influence of her cousins, who were also into that sport. Atilano immediately saw Hidilyn's potential, realizing on the spot that with her physique and form, Hidilyn had the making of an Olympian. Because of such, he told Hidilyn's relatives that winning an Olympic medal was a great possibility for her. Hidilyn quickly worked and trained to fulfill her potential, at first using makeshift barbells made of concrete which was subsequently replaced by a real one. She won her first competition in 2002 at Puerto Princesa in the Batang Pinoy Games, however due to the lack of participants. In 2005, at age 14, she competed in the Manila Southeast Asian Games, and in the 2007 edition held in Thailand, she bagged a bronze medal, which was a sign of things to come. At age 17, she already made history when she became the first Filipino weightlifter to participate in the Summer Olympics. It would also be the first of her four tries to bring home the elusive gold. She did not win, but considering her age and experience, she conducted herself pretty well in the women's 58kg class. In the 2011 and 2013 editions of the Southeast Asian Games, Hidilyn bagged silver. In between, she participated in the 2012 London Olympics, but though she lifted a personal best in the snatch, she was unsuccessful in her attempts for 118kg clean and jerk. Many considered this a poor performance, a step back in what she had achieved 4 years earlier. Unknown to many, doubts were already entering Hidilyn's mind. She was losing her focus and was emotionally drained. Her weightlifting career took a dive, and it hit rock bottom when she failed to earn a spot in the 2014 Asian Games. Retirement suddenly crossed her mind, but Hidilyn immediately found the inspiration to overcome her self-doubts. Training vigorously, she won a gold in the 2015 Asian Weightlifting Championship and a bronze in the 2015 World Weightlifting Championship, which is enough to give her a third Olympic stint at Rio de Janeiro. In Rio 2016, Hidilyn stunned the world when she ended the country's 20-year Olympic medal drought, securing silver in the women's 53kg weight category. She made history as the first Filipina to win a medal in the Olympics. This achievement was more impressive considering she was thinking of retirement just 2 years ago. More than winning silver, it revived the country's hope of ending the gold medal drought. Then at 25 years old, many considered Hidilyn to be just peaking in her career, and with more exposure, support, and training, many were positive that she would bring home the gold medal come 2020. Hidilyn did not disappoint. She had won numerous competitions after Rio de Janeiro, winning gold medals in the 2018 Asian Games and the 2019 Southeast Asian Games. It seems odd that she had won the gold in the SEA Games only after winning silver in Rio 2016 and gold in the 2018 Asian Games when it should be the other way around. but something must be really providential regarding her victories and success. One by one, all the medals in important international competitions became part of her collection. In 2019, she bagged another bronze at the World Weightlifting Championship in the 55-kilogram weight division. One thing is missing from her collection, the one that is the most coveted by every athlete in the world since the modern era, one that has eluded the country for the last 97 years, which was the Olympic gold. Tokyo is the place where she would have that date with destiny, the same place where 57 years ago, Filipino boxer Anthony Villanueva was denied that glory despite beating and roughing up his Soviet opponent. Hidilyn was training for all the marbles, and unlike the unlucky Villanueva, she did not have to contend with biased judges. All she had to do was lift for the gold, lift for glory. But of course, it was not that easy. There were bumps along the way. Controversy erupted when she went public asking for funds for her training. But she was more focused this time around, being concentrated with her training that not even the pandemic would distract her eyes on the prize. Then, the moment of truth came last July 26th, with all her dreams, as well as that of her fellow Filipinos cheering from wherever they were watching. She lifted 97 kilograms on the snatch, then performed a 127 kilogram clean and jerk for a total of 224 kilograms, enough to outlift her competitor, Liao Chiu-Yun, and smash the Olympic record. More importantly, it was enough to bring home that gold, the one which our athletes have fell short in 10 previous tries. At long last, a gold medal in weightlifting in the women's 55-kilogram division, courtesy of Hidilyn Diaz. Hidilyn's story could be compared to a fairy tale, but the hard work is real, and the personal sacrifice is enormous. The gold medal she won for our country is a reminder not only of glory, but all the difficulties she and her fellow athletes constantly endure, as well as the sacrifices they have made for our country. Even after 48 hours, the country is still bewildered, with many Filipinos still not getting over the part that they witnessed history. Something that they never thought possible in their lifetime, which is bringing home the elusive gold medal. And with that, the country is thankful for one Hidilyn Diaz for ending all those years of silvers, bronzes, or none at all, and the inspiration that comes with her hard-earned victory. Thanks for watching. So if you've come to this point, I'm inviting you once again to like this video and also click the subscribe and notify buttons to be updated with our new videos, which we produce on a weekly basis. Go check out our Facebook and Instagram pages, as well as listen to the Game High podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. See you around, guys. Cheers.